Number 10, the Moche. The Moche culture flourished in Peru on the northern coast beginning in the year 200. There isn't a lot known about this mysterious ancient culture, other than they rose and fell surprisingly quickly, just before the famous Inca rose to power. The Moche left behind no written record to tell of their beliefs or traditions. By the time the Spanish arrived, the Moche territory had already been allocated by the Chimul people. What makes the Moche culture even harder to understand is the fact that, in the early 20th century, there was little to no proper archaeology going on in Peru. Many of the artifacts recovered from graves and ancient sites were taken into private collections with no context. Despite this, historians have been able to put together a few clues about the Moche based on the remaining ruins and the few pieces of architecture still standing. We know the Moche were divided into independent areas, along the northern coast and southern coast, with no political organization. There was no monarch or empire to speak of, but instead small autonomous groups that shared culture. The biggest piece of Moche architecture still standing is the Huaca del Sol, a pyramid structure on the Rio Moche. Then there's the Huaca de la Luna, which contains colorful murals drawn by the Moche. We're not sure what these people believed in or what they did, other than craft ceramics and practice agriculture. Scientists believe the Moche were finally wiped out between 536 and 594 during a super climactic event that caused 30 years of flooding followed by 30 years of drought. Number 9. The People of the Cliffs. In the American Southwest, there was once a mysterious race of people who dwelled within the desert cliffs. The rock-cut city of Mesa Verde was home to a people known as the Anasazi during the 13th century. In Spanish, Mesa Verde translates to Green Table, and in the Navajo language, Anasazi translates to the Ancient Ones. Much like other mysterious cultures that vanished without a trace, the Anasazi never left behind any writings about themselves. It's believed they never developed a written system, though they undoubtedly had their own system of language. What they did leave behind was a fascinating rock city containing over 150 rooms, more of a palace carved into the cliff than anything else. The cliff ruins left over by the Anasazi are just as amazing as any other archaeological ruins in the world. According to Life Science, recent research has unveiled that the Anasazi may have had sophisticated mathematical understanding. It's possible they used similar mathematical ratios that helped the Egyptians to construct the pyramids at Giza. However, historians can't agree on how they came to learn such complicated math when they couldn't even develop the written word. These people lived in an area of about 10,000 square miles, territory that encompassed parts of Utah, Colorado, and New Mexico. What's really strange is that the people here just vanished without a trace after doubling in population between the years 700 and 850. But then, between 850 and 930, the Anasazi disappeared into thin air, and scientists have never figured out why. Number 8. The Vikings of Greenland. Some of the first people to ever occupy Greenland were the ancient Vikings. This cold and vast primordial land was settled by Norse warriors in the 10th century. Vikings lived here for about 400 years, give or take a year or two. There are still ruins of churches built by the Norse settlers in Greenland. But what scientists and historians have been struggling with is the fact that Vikings gave up their settlement in Greenland in the 14th century and never bothered to return. For a race of people who wanted more territory and more security, it seems silly that they would have given up a perfectly good colony for no reason. Historians have long purported that the Viking settlements in Greenland were abandoned because of climate conditions. The weather got too cold and the Norse settlers left. But a new theory says this isn't the case. Nicholas Young from Columbia University believes there was no climate change that affected the colony. By analyzing isotopes in boulders taken from Greenland and Baffin Island, scientists have determined that Greenland was cold when the Vikings arrived and it was still cold when they left. So why did they leave? They had livestock, there was hunting, and they even exported goods like walrus ivory to Europe. A new theory says the Vikings may have been at war with the native Inuit, and they lost, while another theory says it was actually the Black Death that killed all the Vikings. Number 7. The Olmec. The Olmec was the first major society to live in Mexico. Forget about the Maya, they came much later. The Olmec lived throughout the Gulf of Mexico, in the modern states of Tabasco and Veracruz, from between 1600 BCE to 350 BCE. In the Aztec language, Olmec means rubber people. Scientists believe the name comes from the fact that the Olmec were the first ones who figured out how to convert natural latex from the rubber tree into something that could be used as a building material. The Olmec were surprisingly advanced. They didn't have a writing system like the Romans, but they did create glyphs and symbols that they probably used as some sort of written communication, though archaeologists have never been able to decode the glyphs. The most famous constructs left behind by the Olmec people are giant heads which they carved from basalt rock. Some of these stone heads are up to 20 tons heavy. It's believed they were crafted to commemorate the mighty rulers of their civilization. Most of the Olmec lived in small villages and towns, though there were two urban centers called San Lorenzo and La Venta, which were used mostly for ritual purposes. Even though the Olmec didn't leave behind any written accounts of their beliefs, judging by the artwork left behind, historians have been able to figure out that they worshipped some kind of shark monster, a maize deity, and a rain spirit in the form of a human-jaguar hybrid. Number 6. The Aksumite. The Kingdom of Aksum is located in modern Ethiopia, specifically the northern Tigray region. It was a major civilization and a huge power during the first centuries of the Common Era. The Kingdom of Aksum had a far-reaching influence, touching parts of Arabia, Egypt, and even all the way to the Far East. The kingdom reached its peak during the 4th century. They had the only written script in all of Africa, they were the strongest trading empire in the region, bartering with the Mediterranean and Arabia, and Aksum was even described as one of the four great powers on the planet at the time. Despite this, very little is known about Aksum today. There are no histories, legends, or detailed descriptions that speak of what went on inside the kingdom. And to be honest, most of what we know actually comes from the Greeks and the Romans and their descriptions of Aksum. What we do know is that Aksum was one of the first great kingdoms to embrace Christianity in the 4th century. Even Judaism managed to take hold in the kingdom, unlike anywhere else in Africa. Back in the 1980s, Israel even worked to move the Jewish population out of Ethiopia to Israel. Number 5. The Kushite. The Kingdom of Kush is another mysterious civilization that had a huge impact on history and is virtually unknown today. The kingdom was located in what is now northern Sudan. It was part of Nubia, a great land that stretched all across the North Nile to the Red Sea. The culture flourished and thrived for over 3,000 years, shaping much of the cultural landscape of northeastern Africa. We know the Egyptians often warred with the Nubians. We also know the Kushite people in Nubia relied heavily on trade. They had a cosmopolitan trading center from which they exchanged goods with much of the African interior, the Arabian desert across the Red Sea, and even the Mediterranean basin. They traded gold, ivory, exotic animals like monkeys and elephants, and in exchange, they often imported things like bronze and oil. But the Kingdom of Kush is a little more complicated than that. According to the National Geographic Society, there were actually three distinct kingdoms here with three different capitals. The most famous is undoubtedly Meroe, where even today there are over 250 pyramids around the ancient city. There are more pyramids here than in all of Egypt, and just like the Egyptian pyramids, these were built as tombs. There were dozens of kings and queens and nobles buried here, though most of their grave goods and corpses were already pillaged before modern archaeology. The big difference between the pyramids of Meroe and the pyramids of Egypt are size and style. The Nubian pyramids are smaller, pointier, and made of pure black stone. Number 4. The people of the Mississippi. One of the most ancient and mysterious civilizations that ever lived in North America resided along the Mississippi. These were Native Americans who built pyramids and observatories and even practiced human sacrifice. They rose to power in the Mississippi Valley in what is today Illinois back in 700 AD. They thrived until about 100 years before Columbus stumbled upon America, though why exactly they vanished is still something of a mystery. The most populous city of the Mississippi people was Cahokia, with a population of about 15,000. For back then, that was pretty impressive. It was actually the largest city north of Mexico prior to Europeans. It consisted of 120 earth mounds, with each mound boasting a pyramid with a flat top where the leaders of society lived. There was also a vast plaza in the very center of the city used for trade and probably religious activities. Along the outskirts of the main city, there was a rich agricultural belt used to feed those who lived in the area. The civilization was also advanced, with a system of government, a hierarchy of religious leaders, and plenty of skilled craftsmen, and even astronomers. However, the great city of Cahokia and its people suffered probably because of an environmental disaster. The first people from the outside world to discover Cahokia was a French explorer in 1673. He found the city deserted and apparently vacant already for 300 years. Not even the local indigenous groups had any knowledge of who built the abandoned city or where they went. Number 3. The Silla. Between the 1st century BCE and the 7th century AD, Korea was ruled by the Silla Kingdom. Silla was at war with the neighboring kingdoms for most of their rule, though they did finally conquer each of their neighbors and unite the Korean Peninsula in 668 AD. For the next almost 300 years, the united Silla Kingdom was a singular Korea, and one of the most devastating powers anywhere in Asia. What's really interesting is just how the Silla Kingdom rose to power. According to the World History Encyclopedia, it all started when tribes from southeastern Korea formed a type of confederacy. The leaders of this confederacy were nothing more than community shamans. They imposed an inheritance system of rule, meaning leadership passed on from father to son. They also began battling and absorbing weaker confederations. Their true rise to power was helped by China, which was ruled by the Tang Dynasty at the time. With China's help, the Silla crushed each kingdom to finally unite the peninsula in 668. Like most ancient civilizations, Silla tore itself apart after taking control of the region. Civil war and political unrest fractured the kingdom, and it eventually fell, giving rise to the Goryeo Kingdom in 918. Number 2. The Norte Chico Civilization. The Norte Chico Civilization is the oldest known society anywhere in North America or South America. It originated in the year 3500 BCE, around the same time that the Egyptians were building their pyramids, and 2,000 years before the Olmec civilization of Mexico that we spoke of earlier. They survived for quite some time, living in northern Peru until about 1800 BCE. At its peak, there were about 30 major population centers, most of them clustered around three large river valleys. The Norte Chico culture left behind impressive architecture, from huge platform mounds to the ruins of complex plazas. They had no writing system, though archaeological evidence suggests that they may have figured out how to craft textiles, and that they worshipped a single common god. But because the civilization is so old, and so many others were built on its bones, nobody has been able to figure out how it was organized, what its political system looked like, or how the society functioned. But what's really incredible is that, so far, there has been no evidence that the Norte Chico civilization engaged in violence. There have been no weapons found, there is no evidence of fought battles, and, so far as historians can tell, this is one of the only legit peaceful societies that ever prospered in the history of the human race. Number 1. The Jiahu Culture. The Jiahu Culture is believed to be one of the oldest from China. Almost nothing is known about these ancient people. The only reason scientists even know they existed is because of excavations that came from an archaeological site in the Henan province, in which scientists discovered human occupation dating back 9,000 years. At the Jiahu site, archaeologists found the oldest crafted wine in the world, ancient musical instruments, and the earliest known example of Chinese writing. There were also ruins found of houses, tools made from both stone and bone, and all the telltale signs of a functioning complex society. And this was 9,000 years ago, way before the Egyptians even thought about building pyramids. It's not clear how exactly these people got here, where they came from, or how they managed to progress so much faster than other places in the world. Everything they did was advanced, from their architecture to their art. But because they didn't leave behind any written accounts of their beliefs or systems, historians haven't had much to go on. We know this was probably the cradle of civilization for Asia, and definitely the start of the great empire that is today, China. But how? Well, that's still a mystery. Which of these civilizations do you find the most fascinating? Let me know your thoughts in the comments, and thanks so much for watching. For more awesome videos, be sure to hit the subscribe button.